There are different parts of the brain activated by the different sounds. And decision making is a very important thing. Orbital frontal lobe here is involved in decision making. And you find phonemic intelligence immediately activates within seconds. You can see it in seconds, this happening. Go and activate that part of the brain. And parietal lobe is a very important part of the brain. It's a large area just after the frontal lobe. And there you have the abilities of comprehension, selfhood, writing, learning, comprehension. All these activities are in the parietal lobe, particularly math and science. And you have these sounds go and activate the parietal lobe as well. So we have now research to back up that these sounds go and activate these brains. What do I mean by activation? There is blood flow into those regions as soon as they hear the sound. Even if you think the sound, there are innumerable research that can be done. So, besides, presenting it as a philosophy or a neurolinguistics or a cognitive psychology, I wanted to bring in a biological, neurobiological evidence, neurocognitive evidence for the sounds being associated with intelligence. The important thing is, I never told the scientists about what sound will do or what functionality is, or what functionality is associated with what sound. They were never told. No hypothesis was given. The hypothesis evolved as they went researching this sound, and then they came up with the hypothesis: these sounds are area-specific or function-specific. And of course, I must admit that we need to do a lot more studies. We have done only a pilot study, and the pilot study is very encouraging. And then we are going to do further studies on this concept that sound can enhance your intelligence. Sounds can enhance your math brain. Sounds can enhance your higher cognition. Sounds can enhance your learning abilities, such as listening, such as writing. All these things are very important for students to know, because up until now, we have been putting all our attention on a pedagogy that involves tutoring. You can go on tutoring people, but if their brain doesn't work, if their math brain doesn't work, you will not be able to do math well. Now, there is research which says that math brain is only a very tiny little part of the brain called the intraparietal lobe. And previously, we were thinking it was the larger area of parietal lobe. It is, but then now we are able to pinpoint it. And then later on, they said it's the angular gyrus. Now they said it's specifically the angular gyrus. Now we see the PA working on that. I'm very excited about it. It's my ambition that we can take it to even areas like where there is no education given to these children, like areas in Africa, and use phonemic intelligence to empower their brain, and then after that, teach them. That's my intention.